and the world of Trans Puerto Rico. Experience the aura and ecstasy of faraway land as our highly trained flight crew fly you in first class air-conditioned comfort. And we give you convenient carry-on service. Oh, está pasado. ¿Qué es una cuerpo?
¡Mamacita! ¡Mamacita! En el último tiempo llevo a tu casa.
Delight in the taste of old San Juan. Gourmet dishes prepared fresh as you fly. And to ensure you're fresh when you arrive, first class leg room with every seat. Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but federal regulations prohibit chickens on transoceanic flights.
No comprende. No comprende.
No pollos vivos.
Oh.
Ay, Dios mío. Oh, Dios mío.
So come to paradise. Trans Puerto Rico. Why not?
The following is a special news program.
This is Jerry Hayes from the Amphitheater in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where in a few moments, Congressman Gerald Simon of Montana will be addressing himself to the current moral crisis besetting America today. Congressman Simon is entering the hall, so let's switch to the podium.
Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow morning a report will be published containing the results of a six-month investigation into the moral decay of the United States government. This report reaches into the intestines of what makes this country work. And I don't like what I see. Do you hear me?
It's your country I'm talking about.
It's you, it's me, it's all of us. There is a deadly disease spreading a plague that is choking Uncle Sam. I want to spend these few precious moments with you, America, to discuss this problem. So if you don't mind.
Oh my God! This Jack Congressman Simon. Security's completely broken down around here. I don't know how badly wounded he is, but they're placing him gently on the floor. The podium is covered with blood. Oh, my God.
What are you doing?
Shut your fucking mouth!
Come on! What are you doing?
Come on!
What are you doing?
Come on.
I mean, Mr. Simon, hey, leave me alone! What are you doing?
Jesus Christ!
The following has been a special news broadcast. We now
Jackson!
Return to our normal
God
program.
Damn it, Jackson!
Right.
Jackson.
He's here now.
What the hell is going on? They just shot Congressman Simon.
There is no Congressman Simon.
The hell do you mean there's no Congressman Simon? I just saw the son of a bitch blown away on TV.
So did I. And I just got off the phone with the Hill. There's no Congressman Simon.
Well, then who the hell was that guy?
There's big trouble out there, Phil. Someone's screwing around with the TV waves.
Has this ever happened to you? Or this? At last, medical science has found a way to avoid the embarrassment of unwanted erections. Now, you may call it by a different name. The rigid rod, the magic muscle, the pocket piccolo, or just the old stiff leg. But whatever you call it, you can avoid it with Stay Down, the new member number from Jensen's Laboratories. Safe, easy to apply, and long-lasting. Use Stay Down and be sure. Virtually no harmful side effects.
Don't miss the Reverend Maurice Fideau's sermon, Man, a Spiritual Assessment. Join the Reverend Fideau and his friends this Sunday on Poodles for Christ.
Oh, right over there. That's a good spot right there.
Hey, you got an eye on you, Billy. That's perfect.
Ha. Oh!
A little stiff. It's awfully early in the morning for me, old boy.
Yeah, I guess you're usually going to bed right about now, huh?
Ha!
Yee! Yee!
Oh, caught me.
Let's get going and get him.
That's what we're here for, ain't it?
Yeah. I asked comedian Billy Boggs to join me in Austin, Texas, because I know Billy is equally at home behind the sight of a 12-gauge shotgun as he is on the stage of a crowded Las Vegas showroom.
Oh, it's sure been a long time since I've been here.
Ah, starting to get an itchy finger, eh, Billy?
It's a long way up.
Oh, yeah, but I think it's going to be worth it, Billy. Yeah.
Well, it gets tougher all the time.
Well, it was a lot tougher without the stairs.
Celebrity Sportsman presents...
Here we go. You ready, Billy?
I'm ready anytime you are, buddy.
Okay, let's go get him.
Live from Austin, Texas, the Charles Whitman Invitational.
Here they come.
Look at that! I got that Letterman! Look at the size of that sucker! He must be 6'5".
Get the one in the yellow sweater over there, Billy.
Clean! I bet you a beer. I bet you didn't even feel it.
Oh, the professor! Get the professor!
Oh, look at that tweed jacket swinging along with me. Ow! Oh, good. I didn't even put a hole in it.
Oh, he sure is an old one. Well, that's it, Billy. We bagged our limit.
Oh, no.
This one sure was a beauty.
Yeah. Well, what the hell? She'd starve to death anyhow. Job market being what it is.
And look at him.
Isn't he something? I bet he'll go 280.
Easy. I swear I never seen a Letterman that big.
It was a good day's hunt, and both Billy and I agreed we would come back next year.
Tonight at 9, Jacques Cousteau cruises the waters off New Jersey on his most daring adventure, the search for Jimmy Hoffa.
Oh, Jesus. 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 Sons of bitches. Jesus. Are you thinking the same thing I'm thinking?
Now, don't jump to conclusions, Phil.
Conclusions? Your ass. Does the president know about this?
There's something on television I think you should see.
Oh, my God. What are they saying about me now?
Nothing, Mr. President. Seems that normal programming's been interrupted.
Why tell me?
I think you should see for yourself.
Oh, I don't have time for this. You come running in here telling me to watch television like it was a national crisis?
I think you should see for yourself.
Well, I want to see for myself.
From New York. This is the evening news. Now, here's Bud Schuller.
Good evening. Today, the Supreme Court handed down a landmark decision on abortion. With the details, here's Susan Lancaster in Memphis.
In an 8-1 landmark decision, the Supreme Court has ruled that parents have the right to abort the fetus through its fifth year of life. With me are Mr. and Mrs. Robert Dorsett. They brought this case to the Supreme Court after struggling through the lower courts for 4.5 years. Well, Mr. Dorsett, you finally won. How does it feel?
Oh, great, Susan. I mean, really great. Maybe we can now start living our lives again.
I'm very relieved that this whole thing is over.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Tear them all up while you can. You're a dead man, Timmy.
I want it. You hear that, you little prick? Dead.
See, this has been a very long and costly battle for us, Susan. I mean, all our savings are gone. I've had to remortgage the house, and now I have two jobs. The lawyer fees are going to cost, well over $50,000.
Was it worth it?
Every penny, Susan.
Timmy, shut your mouth! Let go!
You're an animal, you know that, Timmy? An animal, that's what you are, an animal! Get in there!
In the only dissenting opinion, Supreme Court Justice Walgreen said that he feared for his...
I'm leaving this establishment without Mrs. Lansing's $12.88. We're not through here just yet, Mrs. Lansing. Sometimes these things take a little persistence. I have found that most merchants will come around if you clearly explain your complaint to them. Ted!
Ted! Come on, Ted! Come on, Ted, it's only $12.88! Ted? Holy shit! Ted! Ted, will you talk?
Miss Lansing, I think maybe you should take this matter to the Consumer Bureau.
Thank you, David, for that live report. And now the headlines. Killer bees in Seattle. Killer earthworms in Denver. Killer clap in Akron.
Bill Vorst is a special kind of guy. He's a mailman. To some people, delivering mail is just another job. But to Bill Vorst, it's a dream come true. 12 years ago, Bill lost his leg drawing to an inside straight. Most of us would have given up. Not Bill Vorst.
Hey, Bill, did my disability check come yet?
Yeah, you got it right here.
Great, just put it in the box.
Hidden box.
Yes, to the people on Elm Street, Bill's an inspiration. To the people on Polk Street, he stinks. Fire the handicap. Then nothing but trouble.
Remember this? The sound of metal on metal? A wet towel snapping on skin? A crowded shower room?
All right.
And the satisfaction of a group of men having done something together and done it well. Hi, I'm Fred Dreyer. Do you remember all that? Well, if you do, you're gay.
How long has this been going on?
Admiral Jackson just phoned. I have no idea.
Any idea who's doing it?
None. Nobody knows anything. What are you going to do, Mr. President?
What am I going to do? Oh, sure, it's always what am I going to do. Shit! This is a very touchy problem. First Amendment, freedom of speech, all that crap. Well, call somebody.
Who?
I don't know. Someone important.
Direct from the grand ballroom of the Bellevue Hotel, it's the 9th annual Sexual Deviation Telethon.
And here he is, your host for the next 24 hours, Danny Dubon.
Thank you. We have a tremendous task ahead of us this evening, and I'll tell you why. I know this is hard to believe, but there are a few people, just a few people out there in this great land who are not, I repeat, not sexual deviants. But with your help and your money, we're going to change all that. So let's get cracking, huh? Let's go! Now, you remember last year, we got it up to $2,500,000. And this year,
We're going to beat it. Huh?
Thank you, Dad. Now I'd like to introduce you to some very, very special people. This is Susie and her girls. We're going to be manning the phones all evening.
Get your hands off of me, you Nazi pig.
Remember, the number here is 555-8411, or after six, call Danny at 555-8869. Ladies and gentlemen, a thrilling moment in show business history. Mr. Sheldon Sloan, one of the greatest contortionists of all time, is here today, a man who truly puts his money where his mouth is. Welcome to the show, Mr. Sloan.
Thank you very much, Danny.
You have something for us.
I have something for you. I'd like to give you a check for
$500. $500? What an example of a man who gives from his heart. That's marvelous. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go away. Keep those phones ringing. We love you. We'll be right back.
Tonight, on Educational TV, part one of Alastair Clark's acclaimed British series, Why Do Men Have Nipples?
Do you know me? I was the right-hand man to one of the great leaders of history. I almost changed the face of Europe. I was a man above all other men. But still, people don't know my face. That's why I carry the American Access card. The American Access card. Don't leave home without it. You know me?
This summer, travel India.
I love the morning, with all its natural fragrances, so fresh, so alive. The gentle scent of budding flowers, soft aroma of an ocean breeze. That's why I was so pleased to discover Morning Mist Feminine Douche. Now I can feel fresh as morning, all day long. Morning Mist, in two natural fragrances. Rose petal and Harry. Morning Mist Feminine.
This is the President of the United States calling. Put Mr. Wilson on.
I'm sorry, sir. Mr. Wilson is not available at the moment.
This is the President of the United States calling. You tell Wilson if he isn't on the phone in 30 seconds, he can paper his wall with his FCC license.
The President of the United States. My ass. What is going on, Mildred? All I'm getting is phone calls from idiots telling me to stop it. Stop it. Stop what?
Mr. President, they aren't cooperating.
My children, it isn't too late. This is a good country, and you are good people. Repent now, and Christ and the Pentagon will forgive you. Daughter, repent. This is a good country. Repent, sir. Repent now, and Christ and the Pentagon will forgive you. This is a good country. Children, repent. Christ and the Pentagon will forgive
you. Can you believe that? Look!
What's going on? Hey.
If I worked my hands in wood, would you still love me?
I'd answer you, yes I would.
And would you not be above me? If I were a carpenter and you were a lady,
I'd marry you anyway. I'd have your baby.
Yes, you are a carpenter, and she is a lady. But you'd better not kid yourself. It's gonna be my baby.
Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. He gave you his loneliness. She gave you her tomorrow.
For this very special holiday presentation.
You've got magic hands, my dear.
Nothing but the best for you, Punky.
Prove it. That's nice. Johnson! Yeah!
Let me prove it.
What the hell are you doing here?
Never mind. Get your clothes on. The president wants us.
Holy hell! My pants. Pants. All the way. Here, this way. This way. This way. This way.
Sears repaints the Wailing Wall. Details at 11.
Sally Jones opens her mouth for milk.
He just checked into the hotel dripping with ice. Name Landfair. Checked into room 311.
Very good, Tommy.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me. I'm so sorry.
There is nothing to excuse, my dear. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Count Sergio Walensky.
Oh, I am so pleased to meet you, Count. Oh.
All right, don't you look lovely?
Thanks.
His room is down the hall.
Back away, Major.
Oh, I'm so thirsty.
Lady just got robbed. Third one this week.
Would you excuse me for a minute? I have to go to the little girl's room.
Listen, Manny, I've been with the guy for over 5 hours. He hasn't been out of my sight. Something's going down funny, Manny.
There's a twin brother. Quick, find Dawn.
What's going on here? What's going on, Chief?
Oh!
Who are you?
The maid.
Take care of it.
Boss.
I think this is the biggest score we've had so far.
You've seen your citizens never outlive their usefulness. Yes, at Peterson's, we do more than take care of the elderly. We recycle them.
Welcome home, Grandpa.
Peterson's. just like Grandma used to make.
Oh, my God. Hurry up. Come on, everybody to your rooms. Quick, come on. Hurry. Come on.
What are we going to do? If FDR was alive, this wouldn't be happening.
Yes.
I'll tell you right now, I've got my own mind made up.
Hey, kids, who's the guy with the bloodshot eye?
Texas. Boys, it's booger picking time for Ben. He'd raise that finger mean and hostile. Stick it in that waiting nostril. Here he comes with a green one once again.
Alice, go to your room.
What? I want to watch.
Time for you to go to bed.
Oh, Mom!
You heard your mother. Now go.
Henry, what's happening?
How the hell am I supposed to know?
Oh, Ben Lucas had a lot of mucus coming right out of his nose. He'd pick and pick till it made you sick, but back again he'd grow. Everybody! Oh, Ben Lucas had a lot of mucus coming right out of his nose. He'd pick and pick till it made you sick, but back again he'd grow.
Old Ben Lucas. Turn him on, Saturdays at 9.
They are still a corner of the world where the dollar can buy the luxury of kings. If you desire the elegance of yesterday in a setting as modern as today, come to South Africa.
We'll be waiting for you.
Henry Weidman, president of Urban Oil.
Energy is everyone's concern. If we are to continue to grow, we must find new and efficient methods of supplying our energy needs. At Urban Oil, we're doing something about it. This experimental farm near Baton Rouge, Louisiana, is powered by a revolutionary new energy source. Non-polluting, abundant, and cheap. We call it the Negro. Though still in the experimental stage, and certainly not the only answer, we at Urban Oil are finding the future in the past for our transportation, communications, and recreational energy needs. Pollution-free energy. We thought you'd like to know.
Thank you.
President, they're here. President, as you can see, we have a serious problem here.
Serious bullshit. We've got a national crisis on our hands, and you know goddamn well who's behind it.
I don't think this is the time to jump to any conclusions.
You know, Al, sometimes you make me want to puke.
Phil, calm down. We have to be sensible about this.
If you ask me...
Nobody did, you asshole.
If you ask me, we should all start praying. There's an ungodly force out there. An electronic serpent that's spewing its venom all over this great land of ours. And as God is my witness, as I stand here before you, it's going to bring us down like Sodom and Gomorrah.
Look, if I want to pray, I'll go to church.
I would take that into consideration.
Look, we all know why we're here. Now let's get off our butts and do something.
That's right, Mr. President.
Oh, shit. A new kind of Western. A new breed of hero. Hard Times, 1880. A lawless town, Abilene, Kansas. And a brave man, Dr. Marvin Kittleman. Frontier gynecologist. Wednesdays at 8. We all agree that God created man in his own image. But then, how do you explain the Muslims? This message has been brought to you by the National Conference of Christians and Jews.
This is the 9th annual Sexual Deviation Telethon. Here's Danny.
Oops. We're into our 6th hour now, ladies and gentlemen. I think it's a perfect time for us to go over there and see how much money we've raised. Here we go.
Whoa.
$1 million! How about that? Huh? Gee whiz. Now's the time, ladies and gentlemen, to put your money where your fist is and show... Well, who do we have here? Hello.
Mr. Dumont?
Yes?
All the kids in our pack got together and... Well, we'd like to give you this.
Oh, look at this...
Sure was nice of you to stop for me back there, man. I was really in trouble. You run this route a lot? Hey, I don't want you to get the wrong impression here, man. I mean, you know I got long hair and everything, but I'm just a normal guy, you know. I mean, I'm not a woman or anything.
I don't care what you are. I'm gonna fuck you anyway.
Bixby, the trucker's friend.
Hi, I'm Maxine Waldman, your Action News reporter. All this week, I'll be investigating the shocking incidence of breast cancer among our nation's topless dancers. Join me tonight for part one of Tassels, Tumors, and Tits.
Thank you.
The Paranoids. The story of two people who couldn't be careful enough.
I'll go test the smoke alarm. You check for breast cancer.
Oh, God, Ralph.
Oh. Are you sure your IUD's okay?
Oh, yes.
Oh. Did you take the pill?
Yes. Yes.
What about your diaphragm?
It's in. It's in. And so is the phone.
Doris. Doris, it feels so good.
Do you have your rubber on?
Yes. Yes. Oh, God. I hope this vasectomy works.
The Paranoids. Wednesdays at 8.
In this world today, $1 doesn't go very far, does it? Sure, you could buy a couple of packs of cigarettes and enjoy yourself. Or you could feed and clothe this Pakistani family for a month. That's right. Two packs of cigarettes or feeding a starving family. We know you'll make the right choice. The General Tobacco Company.
Tits. Everybody wants them. I've got them. Thousands of them. Big ones, small ones. Ones behind my knee. Tits on my hip. Tits on my back. Tits. You just can't have too much of a good thing.
Hi there. What's your name?
Who, me? Nancy Hart.
Nancy, I'm going to give you $50 for that shirt.
What for?
It's just a test. What do you say? $50 for the shirt.
Oh, sure. Oh, no.
Now, Nancy, what kind of detergent do you use?
I don't know. Different kinds. Why?
Because I'm here to prove that new miracle magic washes whites whiter than white. $100 for the dress.
What?
$100 for the dress. What do you say?
Wait a minute. You're not going to, Well, it's a test, you say?
That's right. $1,000 for the bra and panties.
Wait a minute. I'm not...
$1,000.
It's a test, you say?
Now get the machine.
What?
Get the machine. Let's go. Let's go. Get the machine. Now let's see if new miracle magic really works, shall we? No doubt about it. Nancy's t-shirt. And Nancy, new miracle magic.
We dare you to come to Ireland.
From the beginnings of time, man has yearned to fly, to soar above the earth and free himself from the bonds of gravity. Now, at Buzzard School of Flying, you can learn to fly. We will teach you the principles of preparing for takeoffs. Ditchings. Radar approaches. And emergency landings. At Buzzard, we teach you everything.
If you were born between 1929 and 1963 and slept on an inner spring mattress, the Surgeon General announced today that you probably have cancer. Taped highlights at 11.
Hi there. Remember me? I'm Bruno, former lead singer of Bruno and the Penguins. Hey, if you'd like to recapture the past, Fabulous Great Hits has a fantastic new record offer for you. Oh, yeah. Who will ever forget that haunting smash of the 40s? Where were you when they were playing this tune? Great hits from the past contained in this one great album. Songs like You Died the Night I Stabbed You, The Love Theme from Godzilla, and my own personal favorite, You Did a No-No in a Punch Bowl of Love. Oh, yeah! That's right. You get 1,500 great hits all on one record. And that's only side A. On side B, there's a bonus, bonus, bonus. 50 top tunes from the Middle Ages. Like Holy Grail, I'm in Love Again, Who Put the Trow in the Trojan Horse, Attila's Theme, and many, many more. And if you act right now, we'll send you a Super Bowl.
And nary a woman amongst them.
Well, how do you figure they survived?
I don't figure. I know. It's them trees.
Well, thank you, Sheriff.
My pleasure, sir. Come on, Bobby Jean.
Are they the lost tribe of Israel, or just perverts? One thing is for sure. They do things differently here. This is Charles Conlon, on the road, with the Woodfuckers of Merleyville.
We believe our Mamorax recording tape reproduces sound so accurately, we dare you to tell the difference between a human voice and a Mamorax recording.
I'm spending in Deutschland, there in the National Socialisten, nur die besten National Socialisten sind Parteigenossen.
Well, is it the Führer? Or is it Mamorax? If you're Jewish, you better hope it's Mamorax.
Mr. President, we've just received the feasibility study you ordered. The expediency of time, let me summarize. Now, there's no way to determine what effect this subversive programming will have. We know it's widespread and growing rapidly. They weren't able to pin down what's causing it. Its ramifications on the country's socioeconomic structure are uncertain.
Oh, for Christ's sake, cut the crap and tell us what it says.
To be short, gentlemen, their recommendation is to turn it off.
Bullshit! Most effective way to control this problem is to go in and blast those sons of bitches straight to hell.
And who, General Andrews, do you suggest that we blast straight to hell?
I'll tell you who.
Mr. President, I think it's time we stop pussyfooting around and take affirmative action. Turning the damn set off isn't going to stop whoever did this from doing something else. I've taken the liberty of putting the Navy on 24-hour alert.
The Air Force is also on alert, sir.
The Marines are ready, Mr. President.
And the Army is ready to go in and kick Bolshevik ass!
Well, that's wonderful. That is very commendable. May I just ask one question? Who are we going to attack? What are we going to attack? And you, Jeremiah, are you going to mobilize?
You can't mobilize against evil, Mr. President. In my opinion, television has always been a damning influence. Humbly, sir, I must agree with the report. I think we should turn it off.
Sir, that'd be un-American.
Give me the Russian premier.
Action, excitement, and plenty of surprises as funny man Jeffrey Hines is a special guest star this week on Celebrity Hanging.
Then, an ecology special. An unusual look at an unusual animal, the last of a vanishing breed. The disgusting world of the puma. Fridays at 7.
Bill and I got married, the one thing we planned on was having a couple of kids. One thing we didn't plan on was Bill dying. I don't know what I would have done without the help of the good people at First National. Thank you, Mr. Sloan.
Glad we could help. Connie will have her family now.
because her husband had the foresight to open an account at First National, the nation's largest full-service sperm bank. And when we say full-service, we mean just that. Our friendly tellers are always willing to give you a helping hand. And naturally, we offer all kinds of conveniences to meet your special needs. Easy-to-use night deposit boxes.
What do you mean? I'm overdrawn.
You must understand, Mr. Merman, you haven't made a deposit in over 20 years.
What about my Christmas club account?
Maybe you should consider taking out a loan.
And, of course, banking by mail.
Hey, what's going on here? I gotta get home.
Come on, man, move it.
No problem is too big or too small.
Mr. Saul, I'm having a problem here.
Why, that's no trouble at all. Here, let me help.
Yes, for Mrs. Connie Ackerman, for Mr. Alfred Merlman, and even for Rodney Lamunson, First National Sperm Bank is the full-service bank. First National, we're with you for the long pull.
In an age of fads, crazes, and cheap gimmicks, you can depend on Bronfman Memorial Park, the cemetery for singles only. Remember, it's never too late to score.
Kids everywhere are turning on to Winkles, the cereal with a surprise inside. And why? Winkles is popped, toasted, flaked, puffed, roasted, shredded, cracked, sugar-coated, candied, striped, chocolate-flavored, shaped like little men or little letters or little animals. It snaps, crackles, and pops, but so does every other cereal. Winkles is Winkles because Winkles is the cereal with the unusual surprise inside.
Got it!
Winkles.
Joanna.
The only cereal available by mail.
In order to prove the unbelievably smooth ride of our 1977 Grand Brougham, we came to Mercy General Hospital and asked Dr. Harvey Burns to perform open-heart surgery in the back seat. No other passenger car in the world would dare to make this test. Are you ready, Doctor?
Ready. Scalpel. My work demands precision and delicacy. The slightest move of my hand could mean instant death. Forceps. Hemostat. Well, Doctor? We made it. And he's not even fibrillating.
Life. Death. Infinity.
This is today's woman. Alive, vibrant, sexy, and confident. She uses Clampax pontoons.
Hello, I'm Lisa Allen, and I want to share with you an easy method of using the new Clampax menstrual pontoons. I know for many of you this is a difficult and unpleasant subject. After all, there are so many openings down there. The doctors have often refused...
Relief starts with an R. R-E-R-L-R-L-I-F-F.
Excuse me, ladies. How do you spell relief?
Oh, that's easy. I spell relief. F-A-R-T.
Educational TV presents a five-part series on the nose. Olfactory blessing or unsightly mess? Part one tonight.
Concentration. Deliberation. These are the ingredients of a chosen few. To be the best. To go beyond what seems possible. These are the ingredients that make a world record holder. We'll be there.
Well, we're close. We are really close. One more phone call should do it. One more. That's it! That's it! We did it! We did it!
Saying? But this is outrageous! You're accusing me!
Accusing you?
He will not be intimidated!
Intimidated?
Just another act of capitalistic imperialism
to undermine the terms!
Got figures. What about the Chinks?
We've already received a communique from the People's Republic of China denying all responsibility. They're pinning it on the Russians.
Mm. It was the goddamn Arabs.
Maybe it's the Jews.
Mr. President, begging your patience, they are rioting in the streets. The nation is paralyzed. Whoever is causing this doesn't seem to be important. What is important is that we stop it.
Mr. President, we must have a curfew.
You've got to
first thing with riding in the
we're teetering.
Come on.
Thank you.